Morning. It's Friday. It's just coming up to 10 o'clock. Just picking up a load out of Hartlebury, Forest Garden, for Cumbria, I'm assuming on Monday. And my job this morning just to take it back to Stoke. Guy's got about another 3-4 lifts to put on. So we'll be on his way when we get all strapped up. And see what happens. Right, we're all loaded. It's 5 drops around Cumbria. Brian's only taking it up to Stoke, so not too worried about that. Let's get out of here. Quite a large pallet of concrete on the back. Concrete posts, about 20 posts on this pallet. They're all strapped up. But, don't stop me worrying about them though. Just take it easy around right hand bends. This is Hartlebury Industrial Estate, in case you're wondering. Drag on 449 back to M5 up to M6 back into Stoke. Crack on.
I think I was
It was well done. Bonus question: shall we dance? I'm going to play you a 60s hit by Martha and the Vandellas, but can you name the two superstars who topped the charts in 1985 when they covered the song?
Bowie and Mick Jagger.
It was. I know that I'm a prisoner to all my friends.
favourite channel. My life's a circus, circus, round in circles. Say-
Right, break ad, crack on to Stoke. Be there.
for talking to us. Have a good day.
Thank you.
Megan in Hertfordshire talking about the bailiffs and the way they affected her. Let's talk to Gillian Guy, who's chief executive with Citizens Advice, and also John Dawkins, who runs a bailiff firm. Gillian Guy, first of all, do you think the government is doing the right thing here to bring in some new rules?
I think it's good that the government is doing something, and let's face it, the government doesn't legislate unless there's something causing them to do that. But from the cases that we see against a background of already having a code of conduct, we don't think this goes far enough, because what it's getting at is certificating people before they launch into their career as a bailiff, and it's not really serious enforcement and serious responsibility being placed with the bailiff companies, the bailiff firms.
Because you're finding you get customers and Citizens Advice who say, I was in debt and it was bad, and then the bailiffs came and it got even worse. Is that right?
Yeah, and it's something when people are in debt and they're concerned about making ends meet, it kind of tips them over the edge, really. They don't know exactly what their rights are with regard to bailiffs, and bailiffs are not clear, it is not clear for them, what rights they have and what they can do. And we've had cases where people have come to us asking advice as to what bailiffs can actually seize, because they've been told they can take the tools that they work with, they take the toys of their children, and we've even had someone come to us and ask if it's true they can take their pets.
John Dawkins, that sounds amazing. You're a bailiff.
I am.
Tools, toys, and what was the other one? Their pets.
And then it all sort of went mad. It was completely unnecessary.
Gillian Guy, come in on that.
I don't quite understand why she was so...
Well, she doesn't have to
say. The guys would have had identification. We're all certificated. We all have bailiff certificates. And if they haven't, they shouldn't be there.
So Gillian, the first caller we had on there should have said who she was and produced her passport.
Well, she doesn't have to do that. She doesn't have to do that.
Hang on, John. Sorry, I'm asking Gillian the question. Produced identity, Gillian.
She doesn't have to do that. And what is more, if she refuses...
Somebody here waiting for this trailer. Cumbria. Unhooked. Let's go get a wash. Because Lucy is filthy. Dirty girl. This is without a doubt the best place to get a wash. They always look after you here, and they do it properly as well. Unlike one or two depots, so I'm gonna have a cup of coffee. Well, that's it, we're all washed, we're all clean. Another week over and done with. Hope you've enjoyed it, and might do it again soon. See ya.